Like my brothers and my friends, even my assistants ultimately don't respect me. You know? So they are all honest with me and they tell me that I have no reason really to have great expectations out of my own work.
Like I remember this one time I got trolled for looking fat at the airport, you know. And I looked at the picture and I was like, oh, this is so mean and all. And then I said, no, you know, I'm actually looking a little chubby.
No, why would we not, why would we take you in the film?
Oh, you took me in the film because boys are crazy on my body?
Exactly.
Oh my God, this is not what I had in mind.
So February is the month of love. Love is in the air. And we have Imtiaz Ali and Sara Ali Khan to promote their movie Love Aajkal. So firstly, you know, there are a lot of expectations from the movie after the trailer is out. How do you see that?
I see
it as a positive that people are expecting that this film is going to come out, which means that they know it. And there's a lot of excitement.
And Sara, for you, I'm sure the expectations will be different because in 2009, it was, you know, your dad who was part of it. So today, when people look at the movie, they'll look at it with a different expectation.
You know, I'll be very honest with you, ma'am. I don't know about that because I don't think that, you know, my father being a part of Love Aajkal in 2009 has anything to do with that. I think that if anything, the expectations are going to be high because I'm an Imtiaz Ali heroine in a romantic genre film. My father's been an actor for a long time and he's done a lot of films and I've now done 3. So I don't think that him having done this film then or anything like that, because we haven't read, acted, promoted, thought anything of this film in relation to the other, you know. I remember actually asking Sir once, is this going to be Love Aajkal 2? And Sir said to me that if I make this film 10 years later, I'm going to call that Love Aajkal also. And then he smiled at me. And for a minute I thought about it, but I understand, I think, where he's coming from, because Love Aaj is different from the love us wale aaj mein. Because now 11 years later, love is different. So I don't think we've really taken the pressure of a sequel or kind of anything like that. That was just a great film that I, you know, really enjoyed. But I think we've also made a great film and it's a different film and it's an honest and new and original film.
And you know, talking about Love Aajkal and not mentioning Kartik, you know, will be very unfair. So Kartik, you have an amazing chemistry with him on screen, off screen, you have a great rapport. So how do you see that?
I'll tell you that I feel that, you know, people have asked me, you know, how is it like working with Kartik? And I think that as a person, he's just very giving and he's been a very giving co-actor, you know, he would do different things in different takes. And I would then react differently. And he was always present and he was always very encouraging. But on set, I felt honestly that it was not Sara and Kartik as much as it was Zoe and Veer, you know. And on set, I think it was more, you know, Zoe and Veer versus Sara and Kartik. So I think that I was getting to know Veer better. I was getting to know Zoe better. Kartik was getting to know Veer better, Kartik was getting to know Zoe better, and I think it's that chemistry that is what I'm so excited for people to see. And it's that discovery that we've had with Imtiaz sir that's just so amazing, because I think firstly doing like a romantic genre film with Imtiaz Ali is anybody's dream come true, definitely mine and Kartik's, we've spoken about this before. And in this film, you know, I think that Zoe and Veer, if we see, are just such different characters, you know. He's in one word, I would say, I think he embodies idealism and I embody a certain level of pragmatism, you know. And to see the way these two interact with each other, I think that's a very interesting chemistry to see, and I'm hoping people feel the same way and come on Valentine's Day and watch it.
So while we're talking about the movie and you being the, you know, the actress of Imtiaz Ali, how do you see the character? Because that's not something that you have done in the past. Even when you look at the trailer, it at times, you know, it feels that it's too much consuming. So how easy or difficult was it for you to do it? At the same time, was it difficult to withdraw yourself, you know, from the character once you're not shooting for it?
So I think that firstly, Zoe is not like me. You know, I think that we are both very driven by our careers and that's a very big similarity, but otherwise she's not really like me. So every understanding that I have to Zoe is Imtiaz sir. You know, he has been the lens through which I have understood this character. She's a Delhi girl and she's showcasing what love is today, which is something very pertinent because love is something that I feel everybody kind of goes through. And as a person, she gets affected, I think, with things around her. And she reacts to that, which is again not necessarily like me.
So you would believe.
Oh, so I would believe. Yeah. Am I like her? So do you feel I'm not like her?
You're not a lot like her. There are differences, of course. I feel you're more intelligent than her. Like you would predict things. You're more reactive than Zoe, I feel, yeah. in certain ways. And in certain ways, she's more reactive than you. But yeah, this comparison talk will be better once people see the film. But for me, I feel that Zoe is the principal protagonist of Love Aajkal.
So, you know, after talking about a lot of serious things, you know, there is this meme culture. A lot of
meme.
Yeah. So the moment a trailer is out, I'm not very sure whether you might
I love.
Because I'm sure Sarah follows. I've seen her sharing a lot of memes.
I just think that all kind of, you know, it's the age of social media, you know, it's the age of memes, it's the age of opinions. And I think that in general, you should just respect all kinds of opinions and all kind of, you know, anything like that. So, I mean, I look at all of it. I encourage diversity of opinions, but I also take most things done on social media with a slight pinch of salt, you know. I don't take it very seriously. I have like a vision of the person tweeting or trolling or memeing or anything, you know. You shouldn't get too happy, you shouldn't get too affected by it, because I think that it's really the audiences that decide. And yeah, these might be audiences on social media, but it's different, I feel. I feel that in today's day and age, opinions are made and broken and generated and regenerated very quickly in social media. So I don't think anything should be taken too seriously. You shouldn't get too happy, too unhappy. You should understand
perfect.
That it's
absolutely
a bit virtual.
That's very smart.
You know?
It's very smart to have
said. And take what's good from it. I think that sometimes, you know, when you get trolled. Like I remember this one time I got trolled for looking fat at the airport, you know. And I looked at the picture and I was like, oh, this is so mean and all. And then I said, no, you know, I'm actually looking a little chubby. And I went to the gym extra that weekend and I was looking really good. So I felt like I did something good about it. You can take positive criticism mentally, you know. People can say whatever they want, but it's the way you internalize it. Eventually, anything that's said about you, if you take it as positive criticism and you try to implement those changes in yourself, it'll be good. But then I feel there's some people that only say things to pull you down, and you shouldn't give them the satisfaction of doing that. So it's a fine balance.
But Intias, I think with your movies, the female characters has always been one of the prominent characters, and you know, they have always you know, left a mark on the audience. They are strong, but they're not conventional, like, you know, the conventional ones. They have an opinion, they come across and they leave a mark.
See, I don't know about conventional, but these are the women I've seen in my life. And they have left an impression upon me. So I guess the stories that I write and the films that I make will be such that the female protagonist or any woman in the film might leave an impression on the audience. So, I have not known women as anything else from this. I've always found them very intelligent, and I've got a very high opinion, and I feel very attracted to women. And
do you also like to drink petrol?
Actually, I wanted to drink petrol at some point of time.
I'm sure that's why, yeah, you wrote the line.
Exactly.
When you come up with that.
Yeah, because you know, everyone, like me and my friends, were talking in my hometown. This is the most relevant part of this interview. And we realized that we want to drink petrol, so that's how that line came.
Okay. So when Love Aajkal released, so you might have seen it as a kid. Of course, I'm sure you might have not dreamed of, you know, being part of Love Aajkal again in 2020. So how do you see that today? And I'll extend the same question to you just by adding, do you think the definition of love has changed over the years?
I go first. I feel that the rules of engagement have changed. Okay, that's also taking forward what she was saying a little time back about then and now. I think the rules of engagement are the same, but basically what you seek when you want that kind of intimacy or companionship or whatever you might call it, and you know, when that is not changed. That requirement which makes a person want to be with somebody else can be spoken, there can be many words to this, but that feeling remains the same, and that I don't think can change at all, because it's been like that all my life. But the rules of engagement have changed drastically, surprisingly, and we have all these 10 years kept. I found myself saying that Love Aajkal aaj banti na to aisa hota. Love Aajkal aaj banti na to aisa hota. So even while we were titling this film. We had a lot of argument about what it could be called. So, but I didn't want to call it 2 because it's not a sequel. It, and I don't like this whole Dabajkal reboot and that kind of you know, it's like, sounds like an action, Fast and Furious type.
Sounds like an action film. Yeah.
So, but so therefore it is Aaj Ka Love Aaj Kal, and there's no other way to say it but Love Aaj Kal.
And you know, you as a director and you as an actor, you guys have different stories. Like you were not part of Bollywood while growing up, and then you came into this industry. You were of course born in the industry. So what, having two different stories, how do you see?
I was actually born in the hospital by two people that are from the industry, but I understand.
So you know, so why, how do you, with two different stories, come together? How do you see that as a journey for the movie?
Let me tell you something about Sara. She might have been born here, but she's exposed to the world.
I was just going to say that I think I'm more a product of my education than I am anything else, which is I think what's her thing.
Exactly, and the things that occupy her mind, the range of even knowledge that she has about how the world is, how people are, different types of people. She's lived and studied in at the Columbia University in New York, and she came out with flying colors, and we are all very proud of her. And she was always a very intelligent, extremely intelligent girl at school, very imaginative, extremely. And also, I feel about you, Sara, that even while I knew you as a kid, you had a knack for understanding and relating to people. Okay, she used to do adab when I used to meet her at her dad's place or office. And you could relate to various kinds of people. You took that forward when you went abroad and you met different kinds of people. So it's also not what you see, but how much you carry from there, how much you take and imbibe, right? So she scores very high on that. So when she's talking to me, she has a range of experience that she can share with me. And she might have had different experience, but the fact of two people who have experiences talking makes it a different kind of a conversation. It's not within the narrow confines of just the present day limitation, you know. So she has a lot to say about things. I have a lot to say about things. I've had, my life has been like, I think twice the length of hers. So I've got more to say perhaps. But she's generally more talkative, so
I was just going to say that, but I'm generally more talkative, so I think it's equal. Double as talkative at least.
So the two stories that we are, the fact that I come from somewhere else and she was born here, it contributes a lot to the range of discussions we might have.
Does it?
Yeah, because I can tell you about, you know, in a small town this happens.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, in return.
In return that, you know, I do this in my house.
But that has nothing to do with what she's saying.
It is.
No.
You know, I've had a different journey. I've been in trains. I'm sure I've told
I've
you
also
things
been
about
in trains. They took us in the school trips.
Yeah, but I've been unreserved. I've slept next to the toilet the whole night. And this toilet was not a clean one like your house.
We went to this camp once called Camp Panther in Nainital, and we also slept near the toilet.
Nice. So yeah, so see, we have so much in common,
see,
despite the fact that we were born in different cities.
And in fact, I was listening to one of your interviews in the past, and you have mentioned that I don't have much expectations out of myself.
Sure.
That's what you said.
Yeah.
So do you think that helps to, with failure
that's
as well
why
as
you said
success?
It. Only so it helps, because we all have expectations from you.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're in trouble then.
Oh, don't say that! He's lying, guys. He's joking. He doesn't mean it.
No, and seriously, I don't have much expectations from my own work or my films ever. For two reasons. One is that you're usually thinking about the film and doing a lot of these, what I call handy jobs or studio hopping kind of jobs. So there's a lot to be done. There's no time for you to sit and think about expectation, about nervousness, and none of those things happen because everyone is really, like all directors I can imagine, are extremely busy at this time. The second thing is that I was raised in a way that I never had like a great feeling about myself or the fact that, you know, I was like, I don't have that. Like my brothers and my friends, even my assistants ultimately don't respect me. you know, they don't say like good things about me and their expectations
and
all. They're honest. See, I deserve it.
Respect honesty.
I deserve it. So yeah, I respect honesty.
Yeah.
So they are all honest with me and they tell me that I have no reason really to have great expectations out of my own work. And I accept that as positive criticism.
I accept that as humility.
And well, coming back to Love Aajkal, you know, promotions have become a very important part these days, probably last few years. So how do you see that?
Yeah, it's very important to put your film out there for people to know that there is a movie, and because there's a lot of noise in media and there is so much news to be covered, so many films releasing, you just want to tell everybody that that this is the movie and this is the date and this is the type of movie that it is, so please come and watch if you would like. And just to do that basic minimum thing takes a lot of promotion. Okay, that was not the case earlier. People used to seek information about the films that they wanted to watch. So time has changed, as she said, and we've adapted with
adaptability.
Time. Adaptability is key.
I was about to say adaptability is key.
So Sara, you know, a lot of directors, I mean in the past, even Rohit Shetty, everyone has praised her for being disciplined, coming on time, having curiosity to learn a lot of things, and as you know, even if as the people call star kid, she has no air about that, nothing, and she's there to work. So how do you see that as a director?
I have seen this good thing about her family. I've met almost all that exist. And all of them are humble for some reason. Coming from legacy, coming from where, you know, Nawabi, so to speak. But they're all humble people. Saif is a very humble person. And her mother is a very, very, is a lot of humility. But aside, so it's not to her credit that she's humble, I feel. Everyone
is.
Like Sharmila ji is, her aunts are. You know, what I feel about her is that if there was a checklist of how an actor should be or how an actress should be and what are the qualities that she should have, think about it, she checks all the boxes. Yeah, she looks a certain way, she understands like brilliantly, and when you work with her you will, or even if you talk to her or meet her, you will know that she understands, she's perceptive, she's easy to communicate with. As you can see, you will find that quality about her. These are important things for somebody to, as an actor, right? Her body language is very good. Her body is very good as an actor. And in every other way, guys are crazy about her and all of that. I won't go much into that because that's not my zone, you know, engagement with her.
Also not true, I think. But
no, anyway. Why would we take you in the film?
Oh, you took me in the film
because
boys
were
crazy in my body?
Exactly.
Oh my God, this is not what I had in mind.
Yeah, so I'm very, very excited. And also the fact is that she's, this bulb is illuminated. I think she's a thinking person and she has a world view. She has an understanding of the universe, and all of that will feed into who she becomes in the roles she does and what mark she leaves on this impression of the Indian heroine. I'm really excited to see that.
You know, I have to say here that when Imtiaz was saying these wonderful, wonderful things about me, and he said, you know, that I, as an actor, like to kind of go into that zone, which is something that we've spoken about. I'll never forget the day in Delhi where I met you in that common area on our 7th floor, and you were sitting there and you were having coffee, and I came there and I was like looking really like tired and done, and like I was exhausted because it was a day off, but I was feeling very emotionally drained because of what we'd shot, like the scene before that, the previous day. And I remember telling you that, you know, sir, I'm really not feeling good. And you smiled at me and said, that's a good thing. And I really didn't understand. And I said, you know, this is like not the way. I thought we were friends. And like now he's like saying this to me. And like, why is he happy that I'm unhappy? And I just think that for anybody, you know, I mean, more specifically an actor that likes to go into that zone or that space, I think Imtiaz sir, like I've said, doesn't make you understand an emotion, he actually makes you feel it. And then that feeling kind of lasts. And for anybody with junoon, for anybody with desire, for anybody that I as a person have decided to become an actor, mainly because I want to be able to experience and showcase emotions that I wouldn't otherwise. That's what Zoe's done. Zoe has gone through a riot of emotions that Sara would not necessarily go through, and Sara does not necessarily go through. And I think that Imtiaz Sir makes you feel actually that way.
All right, thank you so much for talking to Pink Villa. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to
Pink Villa.